The internet is all abuzz over an 11-year-old girl's foul-mouthed rants. Reaction has come fast and furious, ranging from shock to concern. Look for yourself.
I read the comments, I read the messages, I reply to them, but you know what? I don't give a f***. I'm happy with my life, okay? And if you can't, like, realize that and stop hating, then you know what? I'll pop a Glock in your mouth and make a brain slushy.
That's so crazy. Joining us now is early show contributor and child psychologist Jennifer Hartstein.
Good morning.
Yeah, I mean, you've seen this tape now a couple of times, and you see it again, and it still takes
yes,
your breath away.
It does take your breath away. I'm rarely speechless, as we know, and this one took, you know, I really just sat and shook my head and just wondered who was really guiding this young woman, and it's really scary.
And later on, the parents come into the tape and what have you, but just as you're looking at this, as you see it, say it's not her. We don't want you to diagnose her on television, but as you see this girl, what are your immediate thoughts from the standpoint of either pathology or what's missing or what she really needs or what's she trying to do?
What's her motivation, you know, is the question I keep going to. And is she looking for friendship? Is she looking for a group to belong to? Is she looking for a sense of camaraderie and connection? And it's really hard to know, but there's something she's looking for. She's reaching out to make these connections with people. She's replying to their comments. She's having these conversations. So at 11, she's seeing the power of the internet, but not the full scope of how far it can go.
There's a desperation.
Absolutely.
In this, right?
This real sense of, and there's another video where the desperation is so real because these people she thought were maybe friends or she was connected to really start to bully her and really go after her and beat her up. And she really loses control when that happens.
And so here's, you know, what we assume
is
that a parent in the background and she's very upset. And did you not think at some point this would be the result?
Right. Well, clearly her parents are not aware of what's happening. Mm-hmm. I did read an interview with the mom on a blog that said she thought that she was just video chatting with her friends and she was making videos for America's Got Talent, but clearly never went in and looked. Mm-hmm. She never checked what her 11-year-old was doing online.
Right.
And then really questioned whether, you know, her own daughter's authenticity in these videos.
Yeah.
Clearly they're her daughter. And we have to worry about what that means for this kid long term.
At the same time, just looking at the video this morning as I was looking at it, it seemed inauthentic to me. Was this really her voice? It almost looks, is she looking into the monitor? Is she reading some of this stuff? It doesn't seem like whatever is coming out of her mouth is really coming out of the soul of an 11-year-old.
There are moments in this video, if you see the whole thing, where she is purely 11, where she talks about her mannerisms and things and is wondering why she's doing that. So I do think it is really her, and she's dressing up and believing the dress up. It's like she wants to be the princess and is the princess, and she wants to be older than she is and is believing it.
And somehow being the character that she's portraying in this. Yeah, wow.
Right. And really not seeing the consequences of her actions because it opened the door.
Something sort of overwhelmingly sad to me about
this. It's very sad that an 11-year-old needs to go to this length to feel connected to somebody.
Yeah.
And we have to worry about that in the long term for her.
Right. And at the same time, I guess it's also then one more cautionary tale about what our children are doing, especially when they're on the internet, and then clearly the consequences that come as a result of it.
Absolutely. It's what we talk about all the time.
Dr. Jennifer Hartstein, thank you so much.
Thanks.